In regards to traveling with a car, record a notice of a private car belonging to the foundation in the county where which the foundation is doing business in. Have the bill of sale of the car in the glove box indicating the foundation with the care of address and the zip in brackets and without the United States. It is the address in which the police peace officer needs to contract. When an officer asks for a driver's license and registration, provide the passport card, state citizen, and the bill of sale and the certified copy of notice. The insurance card needs to reflect the care of address and zip code in brackets and without the United States. I have personally not obtained insurance for the car through AAA. Do you think the insurance would be an issue so the police peace officer to contract? I don't think. So the element of what you just said is real. I've heard a lot of different ways that people are affecting private side insurance, maybe with a bond, and utilizing that in general practice for being able to hand to law enforcement where they can see that that indemnity bond is over that person's name, naming the state of California, naming the general public of California. I've seen those kinds of things, and they do work. The problem is you're going to have some law enforcement officers that don't understand it, cite you up, and you're going to be required maybe to go and do a proof of to some court, or you maybe get arrested if it's been your second or third or fourth time. For me, even without children in my house where I'm not, I just don't. My time, and I said this the other day, my time, there's nothing more. Gold does not replace 1 second of my time. And I want everybody in this ministry, that's part of this ministry, to think like this, because we're not effective inside. We're effective outside. We're not effective when all of our time is spent on dealing with paper, dealing with problems. You can have complete rest, peace of mind, and without contract, including insurance, so that you are pushed on by the officer. Now, if I was going to make the shift and unregister everything and get my MSOs and not have insurance and have the bond and all of that, which are all lawful, even under Title 18, 100%. If I was going to do that, I would go and sit down with the police department locally. I'd say, look at me, I'm not a sovereign citizen. I am not attempting to be a sovereign citizen. But I would walk them through the law before I ever got caught doing anything bad. And then what I would do is I would do probably a notice on the spot and just say, look, that's why I brought this guy. I'm giving you notice that you've been served and I would, have a formally written declaration of who I am, what I can do, what I'm allowed to do. And that way, if there's any controversy after the fact, like they didn't put me on a do not detain list and the officers were attempting to continually pull me over, there'd be a lot of recourse there. And I could bring them in personally and make them want to make those changes within their system. But, honestly, anytime I see law enforcement get upgraded, meaning you get pulled over by a low-level law enforcement officer, and then you ask for the dispatch, whoever's the senior command at the time, to come out to the scene. 95% of the time, they are respectful, and they know whether your ducks are in a row or not, meaning they'll know whether you're a sovereign citizen or whether you're a state of the union citizen with no contract. There's two people they're afraid of. The ones that have no contract, that they can't find any past expired license, which is synonymous with a quote-unquote state citizen, because anybody that's uncontracted from the federal government is basically, or state government is basically a, and born here, a state of the union citizen. The difference of those people and us is that we have proof. And so when the ones that are uncontracted, and this is like going back to the 95% of all district leaders, captains, whatever, of local law enforcement officers around the nation, I've seen story after story after story where the ones that are uncontracted or state citizens get released. No tickets. I'm sorry to have wasted your time. I've even seen, I didn't see, but this is a buddy of mine, and no reason for him to lie to me about this, where he had made up his own ID. He has no contract. He's been traveling in automobiles and vehicles with expired this, expired. He's doing the hard stuff. And they will pull him out. They will cuff him. They will treat him poorly. And he asks for the dispatch manager every single time. And he told me a story, you know, and this is more often than not. And so, but I don't want to go through this is my point. But he told me a story where that guy came out, immediately had the cuffs taken off of him, called him by his name, said, I'm extremely sorry that he's put cuffs on you. Here's your ID. Do you see your ID in front of you? Yes, I see it. It's his own homemade ID. He said, I'm going to put it in your front pocket. Is that okay? And then he says, yeah, that's okay. And he puts it in his front pocket. He said, okay, you see, I've taken my hands off of your ID. It's now in your possession. Is there anything else I can do for you, sir? And the guy's like, no. And he's like, well, you're free to go. And I'm like, and that's been embedded for 12, 14 years since I've started this journey of coming. I've heard this 100 times. The question is do I want to experience that? Or can I effectively have those things in which will not even have that experience of negative, of cuffs on my hands, bruises potentially, embarrassment, I'm on a date or in front of my kids or on a street around where people know me. Why do I want all that? I have proof that I am not a citizen. And I hold a driver's license in my wallet where I've removed my signature from and where I am allowed to be the beneficial interest on that trust, because that is a trust indenture. That license agreement is an adhesion trust. Why would I want to waste my time fighting these guys? My time is too valuable. Your time is too valuable. We could be altar calling people. We could be doing this. Why do we want to try to convince somebody on the side of the road of our status and standing? It's ridiculous. It's a huge, and the documents you need to do, over $75. What a joke. Is your life that much of a waste of time that you're willing to spend 14 hours creating docs, 10 hours of going to court, potentially becoming arrested for proof that you're allowed to travel without a license? Really? It's right there in the law. The Supreme Court has ruled this stuff. What does it matter? That you prove it to a local law enforcement that you don't know from Adam, or to get a judge to put you on a do not detain? They're not going to do that. It's only the guys that live in small towns that sue the crap out of the small town and the judge that get left alone. It's only those guys. Everybody else, you're not going to go on a, upfront do not detain. But you know what? We are hearing people that are handing that passport app or that passport card and proof of insurance or not to law enforcement. But if they have jurisdiction over their vehicle, they might go for that. You know, they might, any number of things. I would just personally, Donna, I don't want controversy. And I know I'm not contracted. And I flat out have law enforcement tell me if I ever stood up in front of them and they knew that, or they thought that there was any danger, they would just tase me. They wouldn't even try. They just tase me and cuff me on the ground. And I'm like, why would you do that? Well, we can. I'm like, but I'm not making moves on you, you know. Why would you do it? We do it all the time. I'm like, you tase people all the time, and they're not making moves. If they don't follow orders, we do. I'm like, orders, we're not required to follow your orders, you know. I'm like, oh yes you are. I'm like, no we're not. You know, I don't think you understand your oath of office. You may want to go take a look at that before you put hands on me, the Fourth Amendment. You know, you may want to reconsider your thought process because, you know, blah, blah, blah. But I get it. Supported by the Supreme Court, supported by Title 18. I get it. And you don't have to have a license to travel. I get it. The question is, are you in a motor vehicle? Do you have an expired license that you haven't handled? Do they have a way to contract with you from your past? The answer is more than likely yes. And you may have issues. So those are considerations at the very minimum.